My name's Mike. I'm a Columbia College dropout, and Two Failed Companies is my third. It's called Channel Awesome. And basically, we just do online video. Our site has been up for a year, and we're pulling in 3 million people a month. So we've gotten pretty big out of not having any funding. So we just produce videos online and distribute them to people. It's not a culture now. They want to see it right now. They don't want to go out somewhere to see it. They don't want to wait to a scheduled time is available. They want to see it now.
See, I love that. You speak to the immediacy of, I mean, you are like, you're when I talked with him on the phone last night, he's talking about his business model a month from now. That's
every day it changes. I mean, there's nothing you can sit there with. I mean, every day something new pops up and like, we got to try this now, or we got to stop this because this isn't going to work.
Right.
There's no time to sit there and delay, because online you have the ability now to actually change your stuff on the fly. If you're doing something that's on TV or film, you're kind of locked into what you're doing. You can't really modify it right away. So, I mean, and plus online is cheap. I mean, you can do stuff for next to nothing and not have to worry about having a big backlash from an investor or anybody else. Mm-hmm. What you do is immediate reaction. There's no delay in seeing what people think about it. Mm-hmm. I mean, for the web to really become that powerhouse that it can be, it has to have a group of people that are willing to make content that can be something that's a water cooler talk, a Sopranos, mm-hmm. Survivor Season 1, whatever, that gets people talking. Once that gets done, the web is going to surpass TV. Right. It's just missing that one crucial show that gets everybody talking about
it. What is the average length of the clips on your website?
The average, I would say, between 5 and 10 minutes. I mean, we go up to 20, 30 minutes, but generally it's 5 to 10 minutes. Something we want to move past, though, because that 5 to 10 minute clip is still YouTube mentality. It's a quick clip that you're just going to come watch, and you're going to go away, and you may watch it again. But you want people that sit there and that can watch a half hour and be occupied, not be running away, oh, my God, I'm bored now. You want to get that quality in there. Definitely not. Selling people shit, there's no point in doing that. If I sit there and put a cell phone ad on there, it's from joescellphonechat.com, who's going to trust that?
Well, okay, go on.
You're not going to, even if you're a small website, even if you're a medium website, you're not going to get that big sponsor that's going to come in there, sell this new Verizon phone, this is coming straight from Verizon. You're going to get some offshoot guy that's going to be doing his own little cell phone shop.
Well, I'm disappointed because you're like against the old world guard, and you're hitting me with the old world guard.
No, it's not the old world guard. The new world.
You're talking ads. Forget ads. I don't use the word ads.
The way that you get people to buy stuff is you have to integrate it perfectly in the show. If you're doing a comedy stuff, you have to do a comedy sketch around that product and integrate it in such a way where people aren't going to be like, oh my God, that's an ad, I'm turning this shit off.
Oh, see, I wouldn't do that. But that day, look,
it's been working for us, so I'm going to let it go. They still view web video as YouTube. It's a 30-second clip, it's a minute clip. They don't view it as something that can be real content. They view it as something where someone emails it to you, it's a funny clip, and they email it on. It's not a show that people will turn into weekly. Right. And that's the problem you have to do. I mean, especially in Chicago alone, I mean, you talk about online video to anyone in Chicago that's not in online video, and they're staring at you blankly, like, what the hell are you talking about? We heard that's kind of cool, maybe we can do that in a few years. You have to get people to finally accept online video as a true medium for people to distribute stuff, and it's still not at that point yet. It's getting close, but it's not there yet. They're going to still see you as a website, and they're not going to fully respect you. Most people, when you talk to them, you say you're doing online media, they're not going to give you the full respect that you would get if you say you were in television or anything like that. It's still kind of like the redheaded stepchild. But why would you want to put on television and lose all your control? You're going by their standards. Now the web is a whole different area.
Yeah. They don't want to lose
the same ideas. So you look at all the shows now. Everything is a carbon copy of one another. They can't come up with anything unique anymore.
Yeah. Well,
it's either reality or CSI freaking Oklahoma. There's nothing new. But other than social networking, how are you getting it out? How are people finding it? Because basically, my whole thing with what we're
doing... Well, we target groups. You know, obviously, it's easy for us. Vimeo, Exposure Room, these are places where independent filmmakers go.
But you're still limited to those independent filmmakers. Now, in order to get it on the web, to get those advertisers, to get what you want, you have to get to everyone. Mm-hmm. So the only way people
I would disagree with that. You need to get to your target market.
But once you get to your target, you're going to eventually plateau. And then, really, after they plateau, people start getting bored, they're done.
Which is why the internet's going to come and take care of that, because it's anytime, any place.
Yeah.
Right. So then you could be a 30-minute movie, it can be a 3-hour movie, it can be a 4-hour movie, and you can do whatever you want. People, if they're going to watch it, they're going to watch it.
Right. At their convenience.
Yeah, and there's no constraints on you. We were able to grow without using it. I'm not a guy that goes on MySpace or Facebook or Twitter. I mean, we have a person that does Twitter updates for us. I have an RSS feed on the site, but I'm not personally, I don't need to have people know everything that's going on. And with the site, it's done by our people. We're not taking care of it. They're doing it for us. We have our users that are sending it to Delicious and Dig and Red.
Well, that's because your users are like 18 to 25, right?
I mean, that's why we got that ability to not have to do much work for the whole social networking, because they do
more
it for
power
us.
Power to you, man.
Most people will actually tell us in the comments, like, when's this DVD come out? I mean, we had a thread recently where we said we're bringing out the DVDs of Ask That Guy, Bum Reviews, and our sketches. and all these people went. In order for our t-shirts to get distributed, we had a contest where people submitted t-shirts. We had 15 sure. t-shirt winners.
Sure.
We had thousands of submissions, so, and people voted on which one they would buy.
Right.
So we kind of use a site to do
it's
that
like
stuff.
A threadless right.
Yeah, we do the site itself instead of going out to Facebook or MySpace to have people talk about it. I mean, most people, we know what they want, because if they complain about an ad, we get rid of the ad. We don't want them to be pissed off. In order to survive, when the TV giants decide to go and go all out online, you're going to have a set of partnerships, alliances, and new content that constantly keeps coming into play. You can't be one site taking on TV. You have to be an established network of multiple sites of different niches and different genres, and you have to go at it together. You have to become a network online. That's what we're trying to do, and that's the only way you can truly become big online. You're not going to take on YouTube by yourself. You're not going to take on Hulu by yourself. You have to have a group of people that share the same passion and interest with you
yeah.
right.
in order to do that.
I agree with you, but be careful when you say that's the only way.
Our whole plan is to become a network online.
I love that idea, but we've talked about that a million times here, and I think there will be many networks online.
Yeah. But if they're competing against each other and trying to sabotage each other, that's what's going on right now with sites stealing people's talent, stealing other work, copying mm-hmm. other work. You're not going to survive. They're not going to survive.
That's yeah, television. That's, you just described television,
yeah,
man.
I don't think you're ever
learn to embrace that.
Yeah, you got to fight and yeah. just get in there.
I mean, we're dealing with something now, but I'm not going to talk about it.
Okay. Yeah, so. You're first in, man. Congratulations.
Yeah. You can't make money, though, because they have so many garbage videos on there that you have to sit there and look through 1,000 videos before you find that one good video. There's so much crap on there. No one's going to pay to advertise on that, so they're paying the hosting costs, they're paying the server fees, they're paying all that for crap videos, but they can't deny anybody.
I don't think that YouTube is going to go out of business anytime soon, gentlemen.
They're losing $450 million last year, but the thing is, their ads are all Google ads. They're not targeted ads. They're just basic Google generic AdWord ads. They don't have any full real sponsorships for most of the videos.
Right.
Maybe the top few 10 people there have it, but after that, it's just Google ads, which pay you next to nothing.
Let's talk about this Blip TV and all that kind of stuff that you're doing.
They host our videos. We don't have to charge anything to have the videos hosted, and they pay us ads. I mean, they split the profit 50-50. Right now, we have a dedicated Starburst ad, and we have a Puma ad on there that pay us really well, and we're at the point now where we're getting really close to being sponsored on a month-end basis, which is going to be huge money. And with Blip TV, they do all the work for us. They are able to get us a sponsor. They're able to get us the ads, and if we wanted to, we could have our own team, and they'll charge us $500 for 100,000 views to have our ads that we get ourselves on the video. Mm-hmm. But the thing with them is, not only can you cross-post almost any site you want to go to, they have a dedicated sales team there to help you out.
Well,
you can always turn off ads, though, and then get your own ad network in there. It's just the point of getting your own ad network. That's the
right.
toughest thing now for anybody online.
Right.
Then there's also another way, too. I mean, you also make a good chunk of money from donations alone. I mean, we had a big event where we've flown in 26 people from around the world. A guy came from Australia, a guy came from France, and they're all people on our site, and it was paid for by our donators. We had a donation drive for 3 hours, and we got $15,000. And they didn't even know what they're doing. Like, it was going to be for a big event in April. I mean, it's going to be released on Saturday, so I can talk about it now, because no one knew about it.
I don't get that. People just give money, like, just...
If they're interested...
The Million Pixel yeah. Project, too? It's like, I don't understand how that works.
You have to get them involved in the site, and once they're involved in the site, 8% of our traffic is fully going on the site 10 times a day. Even if they don't have money, they'll still donate because they know it's a good cause. I mean, we also give them behind-the-scenes footage and blooper reels mm-hmm. for donating, but plus with online, though, you got a lot of barriers, too. People want to see ads. Well, we only wanted the videos shown in America have the ads, but you're showing in 300 countries. I mean, you got people in Madagascar watching you, not just America.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to have your ads not only targeted, but you have to have your ads regionalized.
Right.
Mm-hmm. You can't just sit there and put one ad to have it go over. What if their product's not in that country? So
right.
why are they paying
exactly.
for that? So there's a lot of hurdles with online right now that I think in the next year will start being solved.
Yeah.
Just you still have a little bit more time before it does happen. That's only going to go so far, though, because you're going to have people that are already fans now. What about people that you might think would fit into the new fan role? You'd have to attach yourself to an established website mm-hmm. that has that audience that you're looking for, and then that they can sit there and promote you.
That's
and most
true.
Websites will do it for next to nothing if you go to the right people. And then you have a new audience to go with your old audience. So basically, you combine social networking with the internet
right.
with an established website, and you've got a new audience.
Kind
the only thing
that's
interesting is when Oprah first got on there and Shaq told her cap locks was on. It's the only time I actually used watched Twitter and actually went to the page because I heard Shaq was taunting Oprah. But
well, Twitter essentially is just the status up.
It's a glorified RSS feed. That's all it is.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, but you have that in Facebook, but you also have the yeah. ability to put photos in Facebook. You also have the ability to put videos in
true.
Facebook.
It's a fad.
Yeah, like, Facebook, on the other hand, is not a fad.
Facebook isn't, but they still have to monetize before they can continue to grow. They're at the point where they're still not making money. Someone's going to pull the plug on them. They're invested by somebody. They'll make money eventually. They're going to pull the plug. It takes them 2 years to make the money, though, when someone else comes out. Now, MySpace was before Facebook, and they were the hotness. And now you have Facebook. Now someone else is going to come out, and then you're going to be done now. I mean, with social networking, this is why I'm kind of against it. I mean, I'd rather have people come to one source, my site,
mm-hmm.
to see the news, instead of relying on someone else's site to get my news. So that way, I'm getting the direct traffic, I'm getting the direct ad revenue, And if they're going to come, they're going to view it. They're not going to be on Twitter. Oh, I see it. Maybe I'll check later. They're going to come to the site.
Your main thing is you want them to watch it in your environment so that the actual advertising is playing. But, you know, there are ways to actually do that through one of these conduits like Facebook. Yeah. And that's what
do you send them emails?
No. It's all, I mean, they all check off. And I have people that tell me they check 5 times a day now because they think there's going to be a new video every hour.
You have an enthusiast crowd, man. That is a great crowd.
I mean, we're doing 3 videos a day now, which is kind of unheard of. 3 brand new videos a day on the web. And it's going to be growing to 4. It's going to be growing to 5. And as we keep going, and we're going to have 100 people on board, so we can do 10 new videos a day, which is going to be like a TV station almost. Mm-hmm.